The Sukhoi Su-57 is the fifth-generation, stealthy, single-seat, twin-engine jet multirole fighter aircraft designed for air superiority and ground attack operations. It's the successor of Su-35 and Russia's answer to American F-35 Lightning II and F-22 Raptor. Its prototype first flew on the 29th of January 2010, and recently it's seen limited operational deployment in Syria. Russian Air Force has ordered 12 of these for its own use, but it seems all is not well with the program, and there will not be any serial production as of now. Russia's Deputy Defense Minister, Yuri Borisov, during an interview with the state-owned Russia 24 television network on July 2, 2018, defended the move and said, "You know that today the Su-57 is considered to be one of the best aircraft produced in the world. Consequently, it does not make sense to speed up work on mass producing the fifth-generation aircraft." He's implying that the MiG-29 Fulcrum and Su-35S Flanker E are more than capable of fulfilling Russian air combat needs. While the assertion may be true to an extent, there's a lot more to it. Several countries are moving on with the development of fifth-generation fighters, and more than a decade after the fifth-generation fighter F-22 Raptor was put into service by America, Russia is still backing away from producing a fifth-generation fighter. In this video, Defense Updates analyzes why Russia's decided to stop manufacturing the Su-57. Let's get started. Fifth-generation fighter jets must be capable of supercruise and supermaneuverability. To attain this, a powerful and reliable engine is needed. Initially, Saturn AL-41F turbofan engine was chosen, but later it was clear that it was simply not powerful enough for the purpose. In December 2017, for the first time, an S-57 flew with Saturn Izdalai 30 engine, which is more powerful. Saturn, the manufacturer of the engine, claims that the Izdalai 30 could be ready for serial production by 2019, but most analysts doubt this and indications are that it won't be able to pass the required test till 2020. So serial production may not start before late 2020 or even 2021, even if everything goes right. There's been a lot of issues with Saturn's quality control in the past, resulting in several mishaps. In case of failures in validation tests, the engine's introduction will be further delayed. Fifth-generation fighters do need a lot of testing, since almost all major components need to be custom designed. Mission systems, sensor fusion, software, low observable structures, and systems integration are all complex engineering works. We've seen how the F-35 Lightning II program is suffering and resulting in huge cost overruns. To know more, please check the video on the above card. Risks of going into production prematurely include having units which are limited in functional capability and not fit for actual combat. Russia most likely does not want to go down this path and wants everything to be sorted out before serial production. The Russian economy is not doing well and it's affected its defense budget. Russia saw two successive years of notable defense budget cuts. This has led to some major cancellation, like that of two nuclear-armed intercontinental ballistic missile projects. Russia is upgrading its strategic assets like ICBMs, and Su-57 is currently not the priority. In February 2017, Deputy Defense Minister Borisov himself acknowledged that the required funding for serial production of Su-57 might only start coming in 2018-2025 State Armament Plan. So it's most likely that the program will probably see no major forward push till 2020 or beyond. Russian Su-57 program has had the backing of India. India was looking for a customized variant of Su-57 for its air force and had put in significant funding. India hoped to acquire around 150 jets. In April 2018, India pulled out of the project. The main reasons were engine issues and unconvincing stealth characteristics. With India's withdrawal, a major source of funding for R&D is now gone. Also, since India's pulled out, the quantity of aircraft that was supposed to be built is now significantly lesser. This will drive up the per-unit cost of the aircraft. SU-57 program has been a very significant research and learning process. This will certainly help any future jet program. Russia may build some more jets apart from the current 12 to use them like tip of the spear for its air force in the near future. This does come with challenges since small fleets of aircraft are generally expensive to maintain and sustain over time. The problem will be even more pronounced for a fifth-generation fighter like Su-57. Russia is already investing in sixth-generation UCAV program, and by the time it manages to have enough funds for Su-57 serial production, a fifth-generation fighter may not be the best place to devote the money to. The future of Su-57 seems bleak as of now, and will be interesting to see how it pans out.
Thanks for watching. Subscribe for more videos like this. Hit the like button if you find the video interesting, and kindly provide your feedback in the comment section. This will help us improve.